still take note, Bunting. The Power of Love. It's the name of the show, in case you just thought this was just the end of the crap. So all tonight, we're doing love songs of all different kinds of styles, all different kinds of genres. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope there's one of your favourites in there. If you're in love tonight, give us a whoop. It's kind of not quite what I had in mind. If you're in love tonight, give us a whoop. This next song is one of the Tom Wallace. This next song is a classic love song. It's one of the great all-time love songs. It's from West Side Story. This is One Hand, One Heart. On Tuesday, so I actually do know this time what they're going to say, and by gum, have we got some stories for you tonight. So, to introduce our next song, please have a round of applause for Roger.
Well, I have to say, Mark's a surprise.
Have you changed the story? You better not change your story.
I was wondering, as I came here with butterflies in my stomach, you know, as you do when you're excited, do butterflies ever feel humours in their stomach? I'm aware, of course, that love means different things to different people. The sort of love that we're talking about tonight is that which enriches us. Although I have to say that late great philosopher Zsa Gabor took a different you've heard this bit, you can tell, can't you? She said, a man in love is incomplete until he's married, and then he's finished. Perhaps you can look at it a slightly different way. Being finished is a really great thing. Being complete is really special. And those of you who are lucky enough to have your other half in the room, as I have tonight, so I'm a bit more nervous than I was on Tuesday. I've completed in a way that no other contracting society does. I'm reminded that sometimes we complain that roses have thorns. We know that love does not run smooth, life does not run smooth, it throws googles at us. Perhaps we need to think, isn't it marvellous that thorns have roses? Our next song is a poem. It's a special poem. And when I started to learn this song, it dawned on me that it was almost a prayer of thanksgiving for all the love that I have in my life. So, see what you think of
thank you.
Flax, the first time ever I saw your face, one of the great love songs. From a classic female artist to a more recent female artist, and a very simple song that was a huge hit a few years ago, and it's very beautiful, it's very simple, and it's a beautiful set of lyrics, very short, but very, very effective. It's Ellie Goulding's How Long Will
Actually,
I Love
Matt,
You.
Before we start, can we just... sorry, this, I just need to say this. 29th of March, 2016 is a day that you remember.
It's my wedding anniversary too.
So we couldn't let it go, you know, unannounced. So Angela, I did for the cool here. And Sue dropping things in the greenhouse at our house, going all over the place. So I thought it was cotton, but it's I think it's pretty nice for all.
Revisit the first song I ever did with these guys. It was at the time when They insisted they would never sing without their music. And I promised I would never ask them to. They know me better now. This song we were asked to perform for a wedding at Gibside Chapel at the time. And it's a beautiful little song. And so it seemed appropriate to revisit in this show. It's called I Won't Let You Go, and it's by James Morrison. Power of love. We'll see you after the break.
Run.